Today, we discuss the gyrocopter in 7 Days to Die. Now, we've got a lot of info to cover and no time to waste, so let's get to it. And I believe I can fly. The zombie jerks are gonna die. I think about it every night and day. The zombie jerks are gonna pay. I believe I can soar. I hate these jerks deep within my core. Zombie jerks gotta die. I gotta tell you, folks, I absolutely love the gyrocopter. Having the ability to soar through the sky, raining death from above to the zombie jerks is absolutely awesome. So today we're going to take a closer look at the gyrocopter. And let's start off by taking a look at the skills that govern the gyrocopter, as well as how to craft one. The gyrocopter is governed by the Grease Monkey perk, which is located in the intellect attribute. Now you will have to put 5 points into Grease Monkey in order to open up gyrocopter crafting. That means you will have to get your intellect all the way up to level 10. But once you unlock Avionics Wizard, you will be able to craft gyrocopter parts, as well as quality 5 car batteries. You also get the added bonus of being able to craft those gyrocopter parts 33% cheaper. Alternatively, you could find the gyrocopter chassis schematic and the gyrocopter accessories schematic. However, it is important to point out that you do not need to find either one of these schematics or put a single point into Grease Monkey in order to craft the finished gyrocopter. As long as you gather all of the parts needed by either looting or purchasing them from the trader, you can construct a finished gyrocopter without putting a single point into Grease Monkey or finding either one of these schematics. But if you do want to go the crafting route, the first thing you're going to need to craft is a gyrocopter chassis. For this, you are going to need 187 forged steel, 60 mechanical parts, 37 duct tape, 60 leather, and 30 electrical parts. You also need to craft up the gyrocopter accessories. This will cost you 49 electrical parts, 8 headlights, 75 short iron pipes, 15 mechanical parts, and 6 springs. The gyrocopter also requires wheels. Each wheel will cost you 3 forged iron, 24 scrap polymer, 2 oil, 15 coal, and 1 bottle of acid. Now you are going to need to craft 3 wheels for the gyrocopter. Keep in mind that the recipes that I've just given you do not take into consideration the 33% discount that you do receive by putting points into Grease Monkey. The gyrocopter also requires 1 engine and 1 lead car battery. It's also important to point out that the quality of battery that you use in your gyrocopter does not matter. So whether you use a quality 1 battery or a quality 6 battery, it does not make any difference whatsoever. I would highly recommend that you hold on to your higher quality batteries for other things and use your low quality lead car batteries when constructing your gyrocopter. And yes, the gyrocopter is a motorized vehicle. That means you are also going to need gasoline. However, the gyrocopter is not a gas hog whatsoever. It is actually rather fuel efficient. So your need for gasoline is not going to be as intense as some of the other vehicles in 7 Days to Die. But once you have gathered 3 wheels, 1 gyrocopter chassis, 1 gyrocopter accessories, 1 engine, and 1 lead car battery, you can craft yourself the gyrocopter. So now that we have our gyrocopter crafted, let's go ahead and slap this bad boy down and take a closer look. First thing we'll do is access the radial menu and open this bad boy up to take a look at the stats. That open option in the radial menu will bring you to the vehicle screen. This menu gives you a whole bunch of useful information. For instance, we see that the gyrocopter has a durability rating of 3,000. So it has 3,000 5,000 hit points. Now that is the same amount of hit points as the mini bike, so it is not nearly as durable as the motorcycle or the 4x4 truck. It is, however, the fastest vehicle in the game. It moves at 15 meters per second. That is faster than the motorcycle and the 4x4. The gyrocopter has a moderate noise level, a defensive rating of 90. It seats one individual and currently has 0% gas. Again, this is a motorized vehicle, so it will require gasoline, which is why we have the refuel option right here. If your gyrocopter happens to get damaged, this menu does also have the repair option, which you can use to get your durability back up to max. All it takes is one repair kit to completely repair your gyrocopter. Now, you'll also notice that the gyrocopter does have a cosmetic slot as well as four modifier slots. However, vehicle modification is not currently in 7 Days to Die. Vehicle mods are scheduled to make an appearance in Alpha 20. So let's go ahead and fuel this bad boy up and see just how much gasoline it takes. So as you can see, 2,000 gasoline filled this bad boy from 0% all the way up to 100%. The gyrocopter is much more fuel efficient than the 4x4 and the motorcycle. Now let's take a look at the storage of this vehicle. So if we access the vehicle storage here, you will notice that you have 45 additional storage slots. So pretty much the exact same amount as in your backpack, and not nearly as much as the 4x4 truck. But all things considered, the vehicle storage on the gyrocopter is not too bad. Now let's go ahead and hop on this bad boy and take her for a spin. Now I'm going to go ahead and jump right into the controls for the gyrocopter, because this vehicle can be a little bit difficult to maneuver. The first thing we need to discuss is, how do you get this bad boy in the air? Well, I'm gonna start with the controller users out there. First thing you need to do is get this bad boy moving forward. So when you're on the ground and you hit the right trigger, that will start your gyrocopter moving forward. If you use the left trigger, you will actually put your gyrocopter into reverse. Now keep in mind, the reverse on the gyrocopter is awful. It is very slow, and turning while going in reverse is, it's terrible. Absolutely terrible. So if you can avoid it, try not to go in reverse with the gyrocopter. So now that we know how to go forward and backwards, let's get this bad boy in the air. So on the controller, we're gonna hit that right trigger, and then we're gonna hit the X button in order to raise our nose up. That will get us airborne. Tipping your nose up into the air will get you off the ground. Now, once you get high enough in the air, if you hit the circle button, that will level off and put the nose back down. So X raises the nose and circle puts the nose back down. Now keep in mind, I am using a PS4 controller. So for all you Xbox controller users out there, you are going to have to look up the corresponding keys. Turning the gyrocopter is extremely easy. All you want to do is use the left thumbstick, and that will turn the gyrocopter. So move the thumbstick to the right and you will turn to the right. Move the thumbstick to the left and you will move to the left. The right joystick or right thumbstick will move the camera. So as you see, I'm flying straight and I'm using that thumbstick to turn the camera around. And in order to enter the boost mode, all you have to do is click the left thumbstick. That'll make you move a whole lot faster, but at the expense of a lot more gasoline. Now there is a little gasoline trick that I'm gonna show you here in a bit, but we'll hold that off until we've done the landing section of this tutorial. Getting off the ground is only one half of the journey, ladies and gentlemen. Now that we are airborne, we need to head back and try to put this bad boy down. So in order to land the gyrocopter, you are going to hit that circle button to put your nose down and start descending. Now, once you get a little closer to the ground, you're gonna ease up on the throttle and boom, just land like that. The main thing to keep in mind is you do not want to hold the throttle down. Once you start making your approach and start making your landing, simply put your nose down and ease off the throttle. That is the easiest way to safely land the gyrocopter. Now, granted, driving the gyrocopter does take a little practice. It's not very easy. It takes some time in order to get it down. However, if you do practice, it does not take too terribly long to master the controls of the gyrocopter. So here I'm coming in for a landing here. We're gonna try to get close to this road. And as we're getting closer, I'm gonna ease up on the throttle and basically just glide down onto the road. Now once I'm on the road, boom, safe and sound, I can hop off and we're good to go. Next up, we're gonna take a look at the controls for you mouse and keyboard users out there. Now in order to go forward on the gyrocopter, all you have to do is hit that W key. That will get your gyrocopter moving forward. And in order to go in reverse, all you have to do is hit S. Again, I will caution you, try to use that reverse mode as little as possible. It is so slow, and turning while going backwards is pointless. It's very difficult to maneuver the gyrocopter backwards just because you move so slow, and turning it is a nightmare. So now that we know how to go forward and backwards, let's get this puppy off the ground. So we're going to go ahead and engage our throttle, and we're going to use the space bar to raise our nose. Space bar puts the nose in the air, and the C key will level it off. So let me get the side view here. You see how I'm going pretty steep angle. You hit the C key, you will start to level off. Now that we are level and in the air, we're going to use the A and the D key in order to steer the gyrocopter. So D will turn your gyrocopter to the right, and A will turn the gyrocopter to the left. And in order to enter that turbo mode, you are going to hold down the shift key. Holding down shift does make you go a little bit faster, but you will be burning through your gasoline a whole lot faster as well. Now there is one little trick that I did want to show you folks. It is currently in the game. However, I don't think it's going to be in the game for long, so utilize this trick as often as you can. Once you are airborne and you get yourself relatively leveled off, there is a way to drive the gyrocopter that uses almost zero gasoline. So we're gonna let our gas get down to about 60. There we go, and now I will show off that trick. So if you hold W and press Shift C and space bar at the same time, you'll notice the engine got very, very quiet, yet we're still going at the boosted speed. However, if you take a look at our gas level, it is not moving. We are pretty much flying our gyrocopter at the maximum speed, but using nearly zero gasoline. This little trick can save you a huge amount of gas, and you can still steer your gyrocopter as normal. However, I would recommend using this trick once you have yourself moving in the direction that you are actually trying to get to. For long hauls in a straight line, this is a great trick to save yourself a whole bunch of gasoline. So we've got a town below us here. Now let's say, all right, we want to go in for a landing. So let's go ahead and ease off that trick here. And we are going to do the same thing. We're going to put our nose down. We're going to line up with the road here. Now you don't want to go too fast. You don't want to descend too fast and go too steep of an angle, because that is a good way to crash. If you crash, you can hurt yourself quite a bit. So we're just going to slowly descend. We're getting closer and closer. Let's try to line it up there. And now we are going to ease off of the gas. So letting go of that W key and pretty much just gliding down to the ground. That's the easiest way to safely land your gyrocopter. Now, one more thing that I will caution you folks about: do not exit your vehicle when you are flying. Yes, it is possible to exit the gyrocopter while you are in midair. For you controller users, if you hit that triangle key, and for you keyboard users, if you hit that E key while you are in mid-flight, you will exit the vehicle and plummet to your death. Be very, very careful you do not accidentally hit one of these keys in mid-flight. It happens a lot, it's very easy to do, and it is a very easy way to die. That being said, I absolutely love the gyrocopter. It is the fastest vehicle in the game, not only because it has the top speed in the game, but because since it's airborne, you don't have to worry about driving down roads. You can take a straight shot to your destination. One of my favorite things to do with the gyrocopter is keep a spare vehicle in my gyrocopter storage. So let's say I'm heading to a town and I want to do a whole bunch of looting. I will keep a 4x4 or motorcycle in the vehicle storage of the gyrocopter, use my gyrocopter to get in the general area, and then use the secondary vehicle to get around town. Because on the ground, the gyrocopter is not very good. The gyrocopter is great at traversing long distances, but it is not very great for in-town use. So I love to utilize the long-range ability of the gyrocopter and use the 4x4 or motorcycle as my main vehicle once I have reached the town I am looting. The gyrocopter is an absolutely awesome addition to the vehicles in 7 Days to Die. Now, if you'd like to see some more tutorial videos for 7 Days to Die, I've created a very special playlist that you can access by clicking the box in the top right corner of the screen. But for now, this is Savin saying thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me in Savin's World. And remember, the average gamer is always king of the hill on the bell curve.